Hello everyone, we're some of the students here at London Met studying youth work. We've got a few students studying first years and one student who's in the second year. We're really excited to be doing this online conference today, and we're just going to share some of our ideas, some of the things we've been learning and our thoughts around the topic about voice and participation. My name is Ahmed, if I haven't said that already, and Belinda's going to tell you a little bit more.
Hi, I'm Belinda Vincent. I'm a first year student studying youth work at London Metropolitan University. And I want to share with you why it's important for being a youth worker. We study to motivate young people to achieve their goal in life. Some are dropped out from school because of social issues affecting them, for example, drugs, alcohol, teenage pregnancy, problem in education, parents, antisocial behavior, bullying, suicide, etc. Also, because young people has been portrayed by the media and the government that they are useless in society, being in gang, it's very important to give them the voice for them to be heard, and also making them feel positive in society and making them feel they are not left out. Promoting equality and diversity is also another important role and skill needed for a youth worker, and it's also important to enable them to achieve their goal in life.
Hi, my name is Matthew Campbell. I'm also a first year student. I'm here to discuss the Hearts Ladder and the importance of participation. As a society, we tokenism young people all the time, and unless we give them a voice, participation will be minimal. Hearts Ladder helps identify different levels of participation. As youth workers, we aim to tackle the first three levels of non-participation by informing and consulting young people. To help to cover joint decisions, young people deserve to have their voice and opinion heard in order to help shape the community they are part of. Instead of dictating and manipulating young people for the adults' gain, we need to empower and advocate young people to ensure we are connected with issues surrounding topics relevant to them.
Hello, my name is Charlene Sago. I'm a second year student here at London Met studying youth work. This year I was involved in a placement for my studies where I underwent 150 hours. Now, even before I start my placement, lectures here was able to help in terms of preparing me for what I may face whilst out on placement. So I was reading up books from authors such as Neil Thompson on anti-oppressive practice, and also from Kate Stapen, Essential Skills for Youth Work. And I was able to use what I've learned through lectures and through my own reading on participation and how to involve young people to participate in the activity. I was working in a school where young people felt like they didn't want to really socialise with other peers from maybe different races, different age groups as well. But through participation, you're able to engage not only between them, but with them also, so that young people may also feel that they can come to you whenever they feel like they need someone to speak to. And we as youth workers are here to help motivate and encourage them. We're not there to judge, we're not there to criticise, we're there to help them and encourage them to do what they want to do, and also let them know that they have a voice.
We just want to say it's really great that we have the opportunity to be involved in this conference. And as we know right now, the funding for youth work is really dropping, and it's really important that all the youth work professionals and organisations can come together to work collaboratively so we can get the most effective and efficient youth work practice out there available, so that we can all share our ideas, so we can just best improve young people's lives and how they live.
I just wanted to say, because at the end of the day, young people are our futures, so we should look out for them and we should stand for them.
Bye.